My guest today is Sarah Kohler, founder of TwentyBliss.com, a platform which both empowers creative 20-somethings to express themselves and curates independently organised exhibitions and events for this often lost internet demographic. Born and raised in Hong Kong, I started off asking this modern-day impresario how she got started here and how TwentyBliss all came about.
So when I started TwentyBliss, it was just an idea for a blog that I had. And it was, like I said, it was a transitional period, and BuzzFeed was really churning out these listicles, which they're calling now, you know, like 20 reasons you know you're in your 20s. And, you know, it's fun and interesting, but when there's about five of them every single day, it gets tiring. But also I wanted to hear actual stories instead of being just a list of generalized feelings that didn't necessarily apply to every single person, or they just seemed really vague. And so, which is why I started the blog, and I wanted to ask people what I was asking myself, which is, what did I want to achieve, or what did my 20s mean to me, or what happens after you graduate?
And so the people that have now have become attracted to your blog, what brings them back? What's going on 20-something that, on 20bliss that's making your audience grow in the way that it is?
I think the internet is inherently very social and ever-changing, and I think this is my favorite thing about it, is that I'm allowed to change and grow with it. And so I was asking my readers that question and to write to me about that. And every single time I had new doubts or questions or just worries in life, I guess, I would write to them, and it would be this conversation almost. And then as it was growing, more and more people were writing to us, meaning that indirectly they were also speaking to each other, and it just slowly became a community. And then we expanded in content with interviewing emerging artists, and you know, it shows that everyone who is creative is afraid to put something out there. It's scary, but that's okay, and you don't have to do it alone. So that's what the site is there for.
Is there another site similar to yours that's out there in the blogosphere?
I'm sure there is. There's a ton of them on Tumblr. There's this one called The Only Magic Is Art, but I actually know the guy. He's from San Francisco. He's called Brendan, and he focuses more on just featuring people, as in he'll post their work, but there's not as much written content, I guess. So it's nice to see other blogs that are doing that, but like I said, the internet is so social, people easily come together, and it wasn't like we were competing against each other. If anything, we saw it as like we could, you know, maximize on this. And he had a huge following as well, so that really helped in bringing 20bliss into the internet spotlight.
So how big is your tribe now, and what sort of?
It's about 1,700 or 1,800, and interestingly, about 40% of them are from the U.S., which I think I owe that to Brendan. Yeah.
So is it still very much a labor of love for you at the moment? Have you found a way
yes.
to monetize it?
Yes, absolutely. I recently started Urban Hacks, which is a new creative initiative that I wanted to experiment with, which happened last month. And it's something that I could perhaps partner up with brands and other venue spaces to hire us to create this concept for them, or this event. And it's really focused on the idea of engaging the community and breaking down that barrier between creatives and, I guess, non-creatives, so to speak, because I feel like there's this fear of people always saying like, oh, I'm not creative, I can't draw or something like that, which is not true. I think everyone is a little bit creative. It doesn't matter.
Yes, I have discovered something quite interesting about one's latent ability to be an artist, if you will. Because when I started my own immigration blog and my own immigration website, where I reached out to my tribe and positioned myself to answer questions and help solve problems, in imparting that know-how and that expertise, I needed a way to do it in an engaging way.
Yeah.
And that made me think about how I was going to construct that proposition. And so it's given me opportunities to create art, and if you look at our websites, we've got some really interesting things going on that are different. So I agree with you that people do have latent artistic capabilities that can be showcased through self-publishing via the web. So Urban Hacks, how does that work?
So we really focused on the idea of everything being created on the day. One of the artists, Lauren, actually had this really great idea. It's so simple. She set up a canvas on the day, and she got people to write from A to Z, and choose a number from 1 to 6, and that directly corresponded with a space on the canvas and a color, and that was it. And even though it was so simple, some people were still so afraid and just, you know, being like, oh no, I'm okay. And I'm like, no, if you don't participate though, this artwork will not happen. And then that, I feel like that made them want to give back to me in a way, or to help me out in a sense, because I'm like, that canvas is gonna stay blank if you don't do anything. So I think that's something, it was very experimental, and it was interesting to see how so many people chose B2, and there was a huge blue spot on it. And I think that's something we want to continue for the rest of the year, and maybe keep on adding to it. So now this painting sits in Lauren's house, but I'm hoping to bring it back out, and maybe next time will be different.
When you look at your ability to produce content, and you look at the state of the business market in Hong Kong and the use of the internet through sophisticated presentation of content for commercial ends, where do you see opportunities for you and your generation?
I think there's so much. I say that, I know I'm only 24, but I see 17-year-olds now, and that wasn't that long ago for me, but they're definitely smarter than when I was 17 because of the internet. And the internet's getting better and better every single day, but when I was, I think Twitter was just starting when I was 17, something like that. And Twitter was used to complain about school and homework. I mean, not that I don't complain on Twitter anymore, but, you know, it is a marketing tool as well. And you can meet people through Twitter. And it's weird to think about that now, because you grow up with your parents saying, don't talk to strangers. And now every single day, your kid is online talking to a million strangers. But it could be good for their career.
So clearly you have an orientation towards the internet.
Yes.
That is very much of the age. How would you say that your orientation towards the internet is different from your parents' orientation towards the internet?
Well, for one, my mom called the hashtag a pound sign the other day. So it's strange to explain to them. And I say that like my parents are ancient. They're really not. They're quite young parents. But it is weird to them to think that, you know, my kid is on her computer all day. What the hell is she doing? But, you know, it's like, no, I'm networking in a way. I don't know. It's strange. It's so hard to explain to them and tell them that this is a time where the internet has allowed us to be ourselves, almost, because there are no gatekeepers. You can say whatever you want on Twitter. And with 20bliss, I can say whatever I want. Maybe not now, but when I first started, it's, you know, I can say whatever I want on that because it was more of a personal blog for me. And people like that. You know, there's, just don't lie on the internet because there are so many other blogs, there are so many other Twitter accounts, so many other Instagrams. If you're not authentic, people can tell eventually. And they don't have to stick around. It's one button and you're done, gone forever in their lives from their newsfeed, which sounds so harsh, but yeah.
What have you learned with 20bliss that will carry you through to perhaps another, the next phase of your career when you're in your late 20s, early 30s, and you're really out there to make a mark?
I think just embracing who you are, which sounds really cheesy, but going back to what I said earlier about being authentic.
Authenticity.
People can tell. And if you're not producing authentic content, then why are you doing it? And why is it fun for you if you don't honestly and truly believe in what you're putting out there?